see it's already got quite a bit of curve in it just from one little session. Now, you can see the edges get all ruffled up. Now you can either take it to the tucking machine and form some more tucks in it and start shrinking that, or you can just smooth that a little bit on the post dolly and then go back and stretch some more. You actually shrink a little bit by smoothing it on the post dolly. I'm going to do a little bit of that. That'll make it easier to pound out some more shape without hitting the wrinkles. You'll notice that as you take these wrinkles out, we get less curve going in this direction, so we're getting kind of a false curve by having all those wrinkles in there. So every time we take the wrinkles out, we get back to what we actually have, which is a more shallow curve this way. Okay, that's three quick sessions of the mallet. And now I'm going to smooth this one more time, and then I'm going to take it to the tucker and run a series of tucks along each side. You can see I've formed the tucks up inside because I like pounding over a flat surface to get my tucks flattened out. But you can see that this is going to interfere with swinging the hammer. So one way to fix that is to bend it like that so that you get that leg out of the way. We're going to have to do our tucks to the outside once we get a little bit more curve going this way, because we're not going to be able to reach the tucks otherwise. But you can actually cheat a little bit by just manipulating the metal out of the way, unbending. Okay, that's one side, doing the medium-sized tucks. That out a little bit. Okay, that's one more session of stretching. It's starting to get so deep, I decided to use a hammer that reaches in a little bit better, with a nice high crown on it for really good stretching. And then I smoothed it a little bit, and now I'm going to change the direction of the curve a little bit to make it easier to run through the English wheel. First, I'm going to run it through under no pressure, just a light pinch between the wheels. This helps me take out some of the little lumps. Actually pinching the metal now a little bit. That gave us a little bit smoother panel to work with. What I want here is more shrink on the very edge, so I'm going to trap the edge and just shrink right there. And the rest of it I'm just going to kind of let escape. I'm going to pound it out, but I'm not going to really be trying to get it to shrink right there. So I could have done the shorter tucks, but I got a little carried away. Not hitting really hard, just enough to smooth it a little bit, and then later on I can go over a little bit harder to flange. Now this would fit a certain size tire with that particular crown in it. Now if we wanted to fit a smaller diameter tire and have less crown, all we'd have to do is reconfigure the metal by bending it like that, and we'll get a smaller diameter here and a lower crown in this direction. I've put about 4 hours into this, mostly by hand so far. And you can see we've made some progress. We have more curve in both directions, actually. But we're going to need a lot more if we're going to fit that small diameter tire that I chose. So I'm going to try a method that's a little bit faster. And you can see just one session with the nibbler with the thumbnail dies, the thumbnail shrinking dies in it, give us a lot more shape. That took maybe 10 minutes or something, and then I spent a couple minutes smoothing it a little bit on the English wheel.